I love you, man.
I love you too.
To ask Libby to marry me.
Will you marry me?
Show your house to have some fun. Is there anyone in there?
Joe, where are the kids?
Oh, wait, is she with you?
She's still in the toilet.
Oh, God, come on.
Tess, that cut on your face. Did Brendan hit you?
Yes.
Kennedy.
I'm with Louise Carpenter. Her father's interstate. Who's on duty in recess?
Dr. Olensky.
Oh, excellent. Could you keep an eye on Drew Kirk for me? He's got partial thickness burns to the lower dorsum. He's my daughter's boyfriend.
Okay. Where's Rexy?
Oh, no. I saw him. He's all right. Don't worry, love.
He might be inside.
No, I saw Tony take him to the back of his place. He's fine.
Rexy's the last of our worries.
Oh, no, Joel. You're not going in there yet. It's not safe.
Darling, look, I'm just going to check it out with these blokes. I'll be fine. You take the kids to Susan's, okay?
Come on. Let's go inside. There's no point hanging around out here.
Find a seat, sit down, make yourselves at home, then. There you go.
Can I do anything?
Yes, you could find as many blankets as you can. Just take them off the bed.
Okay.
Are you feeling cold, love?
No, I just can't stop shaking.
I'll make some hot tea.
You're all right, love. We're all fine now.
I'm not even cold. I just can't stop shaking. Yeah.
I want to go with Dad and check out the damage.
Don't be such a ghoul.
Just stay here, Flick.
Can I help? Yes. Milk's in the fridge. You right there, Lynn?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sure that little girl's okay.
Ah, here we go. Oh, this'll warm you up. That's it. Well, looks like you might be staying here tonight.
Oh, no. Joe'll be back in a minute and we'll know what the damage is. I'm sure the bedrooms will be fine.
I don't want to go home.
All right, mate, I'm the owner.
How are they?
Oh, well, not bad, really, considering.
When can I see Drew?
Well, I'll tell you, darling. You have to be patient.
Yeah, I know. It's just hard waiting.
How much damage do you reckon has been done to the Scullies?
Oh. Dr. Kennedy?
Yeah.
Dr. Olensky thinks they should keep Louise in tonight.
Oh, well, that's fair enough.
And she's asking for a daddy.
Oh, right. Well, Dad won't be back until tomorrow. If then, he's stuck in floods up Tharmaginderway. But I'll go and sit with him.
What about Drew Kirk? Do you know what's happening?
You a relative?
Not really.
Well, he's in the burns unit. All right, as far as I know. I'll see if I can find someone to come out and have a word.
Well, if you said you're engaged to him, then I'd let you in.
I'll leave you to it. Thanks, mate.
Go.
Oh, it's okay. How much longer do you reckon? So you're gonna marry him?
I don't know. I can't think about that now. And I don't even know.
Yeah. Well, the whole street's gonna reckon it's a foregone conclusion.
Can't make decisions about my life because of what the whole street thinks.
No. Can you see yourself married?
I don't know, really. Sure, eventually. Can't you?
Yeah, eventually.
But I'm not sure if I'm ready for the fuss Mum will make.
Are you kidding? Dad would be heaps worse.
Yeah.
But that's no reason not to go through with it.
What? Sorry.
The way Dad will be, it's no reason not to go through with it.
Why are you so keen?
Oh, man, you've dated lots of duds. This is the first decent guy you've actually managed to score. I think you should grab him before he gets away, hey?
Well, that's a big put down. Oh, anyway, you can talk.
Well...
Something's happened, hasn't it?
Maybe.
And?
Mm-hmm.
Good, good. You've been a pain to live with since you two broke up. Listen, you shouldn't be hanging around here. Where is she?
Oh, she might have gone home to the Greenwoods. Then she might still be at Toadie's.
Yeah. Will you go? Please. I'll be fine. Dad's here and I can call you if I need you.
You sure?
Yes. Go.
All right. I'll give my best to Drew when you say him.
I will.
Come here. I don't know what's going on. She landed all right. She should have been here ages ago.
Oh, maybe they had celebratory drinks.
She said she'd come straight here. She would have rung if there'd been a change of plans.
And we're talking about Amy Greenwood, the party animal of Erinsborough. Mate, she gets a sniff of a party and her brain goes into overdrive.
It does not. Well, that's hot.
Kate, no. No more jokes.
Anyone here?
Yeah, in here.
Oh, hey, how are they?
Oh, okay, more or less. They're keeping them in overnight.
Did Lolly get any burns?
No, it was just the smoke. Drew was still in the Burns unit when I left. I'm not sure how he is.
Jeff, Lance, g'day.
Hey, do you mind if I crash here tonight? All the Scullies are over at my place. And Teresa's there too. It's a bit of a full house.
What, is Teresa staying too?
I don't know. Something funny's going on though.
Yeah, dude, you're welcome. Are you going back to Greenwoods?
Yeah, I guess so. I hate staying when Amy's not there though.
So stay here? Come on, you can't resist a sleepover at the Toads. I'll make you fairy bread, come on!
Well, I better say yes then. Everything's black.
Ah, oh, that's just smoke. That'll wash off.
Oh, it stinks.
Yeah, well, that'll go too.
Well, bedrooms are fine. Steph's door was shut. Your room's nearly perfect, love.
See what I told you? Bit of soap, bit of airing, lick of paint, this place will be like new.
Not exactly like new.
Such a shame, you know. It was only painted about 6 months ago.
Oh, Mum never liked the colours anyway.
Stephanie.
It's the pits. We can't even cook in here.
I've already thought of that, Flick. As soon as the shop's open, I'm going to get a microwave, one of those toasty thingamajigs, electric jug. That'll keep us going for a week or so until I can get the kitchen up and running again.
Take a bit more than a week, love.
Hey, talking to Joe Scully, the builder, remember?
Oh, yeah, Joe Scully, the builder.
Looks like someone had a barbecue on our table.
Yeah, well, they reckon that's where the fire started. There were sparklers on top. Lolly must have set a match to them.
And you let her?
Hey, none of that. Let it go, Flick.
Unbelievable. I can't believe the way you spoil her. She almost burns the house down and you just let her.
Felicity!
I should probably be heading back. Look, you're more than welcome to stay at our place tonight.
Oh, no. No, no, thanks, Susan. We'll be fine.
Yeah, thanks for your help. Hey, come on. Let's check out your room, eh? Oh, I'm beginning to wish we'd never moved here.
Why, what's this? Oh, come on, love. It's not like you to give up after one little setback, eh? Come on.
Oh, you're right. We'll wash it down with a coat of paint. You're right.
We'll be right, darling. You're right.
Anyway, I'm off next door. I'll see you later.
See you, darling.
Oh, sorry. Almost said, where's the fire?
How's Lol?
She's good. She's good. I came home because she's having a sleep.
Yeah, yeah. All right. See you later.
Yeah. Bye. Oh, hello, Teresa.
Hi.
Lolly's asking for Lou.
We're going to have to phone him.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's too late now. We'll call him in the morning. Yeah. I'm not looking forward to it either. At least we can tell him she's all right.
Look, I might just go in there. I don't want her waking up and having nobody beside the bed.
Sweetheart, she'll be asleep for a few hours yet.
Still.
So, Teresa, how are you bearing up?
Oh, fine. I wouldn't dare complain after the night your neighbours have just had.
Yeah, well, where are they, by the way?
Home. They insisted. I went over there. The kitchen's ruined, but the rest is pretty livable.
They got a hell of a job ahead of them.
Mm. Actually, I think I should go too.
Oh, look, I won't be long. I just don't want to leave Louise alone in the hospital.
Oh, of course not.
Why don't you stay here? Look, it's almost dawn. There's no point going anywhere. The house is empty. Billy's next door. Libby will be at the hospital for ages.
Well, if you're sure it's no bother.
Of course it's not. Is it, Carl? You'll make her welcome, won't you?
Oh, yeah. In my usual churlish way.
Well, it's settled then. I'll see you in a couple of hours.
You're still here?
Of course. How are you feeling?
Oh, vague.
Yeah, it must be what they gave you for the pain. You keep drifting off to sleep.
Do I? Oh, yeah, I guess I do. It's working, whatever they gave me. How's Lolly?
She's fine. They're keeping her overnight.
Some party.
Yeah, some party. You were the hero of the night.
Get out of here.
You were.
Oh, no. I'm not asleep. Just parts of me are.
Well, maybe all of you should be.
Do you remember what I asked you?
Yeah.
And?
Let's talk about it in the morning, okay? When we're both making sense. Is there any part of you that's not too sore for me to kiss?
I don't know. Try. That's good.
What about here? Oh, Mrs. Kennedy. Dr. Kennedy left about half an hour ago.
Oh, I know. Now I'm doing the next shift. How is she?
Sleeping peacefully. You really don't need to be here, you know.
Oh, I know. I'd rather be.
There's something about a sleeping child, isn't it?
Mm,
I know. I'll get you a pillow.
Now you should go back to bed. You haven't had enough sleep.
Oh, I'm fine. Give them my love. Tell them I'll be in a bit later on.
Yeah, I'm going to pop over and see Harold and fill him in on the Lolly situation. Then I'll see the Scullies. I've got to find Lolly's teddy. She's asking for it.
Everyone. Billy's next door. Your dad's just gone off to the hospital and I think Tess is still asleep.
What's the story with her?
Well, it's complicated. Would you like some toast?
Please. Meaning none of my business?
Meaning I don't know that much about it myself. She needed a place to stay last night, that's all.
Are you going to have the next shower or can I?
Oh, you can if you're in a hurry.
Oh, yeah, I want to get to the hospital early. Mum, do you think I'm too young to get married?
Well, if you need to ask your mummy, you probably are. Bit of a surprise, wasn't it?
No. You were married at my age.
Libby, that doesn't make it a family rule. Have you given him any sort of an answer?
No, I didn't know what to say. I was so shocked. And then the fire started.
Oh, well, if you need to take the time, then you should take it.
I will. I don't want to hurt him.
Of course you don't. He's a lovely man. Oh, who's this? Hello?
Oh, hi, Mrs. Kennedy. Yeah. I'm Ron Kirk. This is my wife, Rose.
Oh,
Drew Kirk's parents. Hi, Libby.
Hi. Did you know you were coming?
No, it's a surprise. We had to drop Doogie at scout camp and then we just kept on driving.
Yeah, we called in over the road, but there was nobody home, so we figured he'd be right here with his bride-to-be.
And we're so delighted. Congratulations. Isn't it wonderful?
We can find our way.
Oh, I'm heading down there anyway, so I may as well come with you.
You can take my car.
Oh, our car's just out the front, thanks.
Yeah, you just point us in the right direction.
Well, give him my love. I'll be down later.
Oh, you won't need to. He'll be out today, tomorrow at the latest.
I still can't believe it.
No, he's fine.
Oh, you're awake. Oh, how could you not be with all the noise we made? Did you sleep all right?
Yeah, fine. I was up a while ago, actually. Just didn't want to interrupt you while you had visitors.
Oh, you're not an interruption.
How's Louise?
She's doing fine. Carl's with her. Come on, coffee's hot. I'll get you one.
No, I'm fine, thanks. Look, Susan, you've been incredibly kind. I just think I should get going before everybody comes back. Oh,
Tess, it's been a hell of a night for all sorts of reasons, but you mustn't feel unwelcome. We've got the house to ourselves. You might as well stay a bit longer. Come on. I'll make you some breakfast.
Oh, that's the assessor. He'll be down this afternoon. Any of that for me?
Can we boil water?
Electric jug. I'll put that on the list. You'll be able to boil water by lunchtime, so don't look so depressed. It'll be like camping.
It's nothing like camping. Anyway, camping sucks.
No, it doesn't.
If that's Harold with another quiche, I'm gonna...
You are going to accept it with pleasure.
Hello, Joe. Hello, everyone.
Oh, hi, Carl. How's Lottie?
Oh, yeah, not bad. I'm on my way to the hospital now. I just came past to get a teddy. Apparently she left it here.
Well, it's in the kitchen.
All right.
Do you think she'd let us buy her a new one?
Oh, don't worry about that. She's got plenty of toys. Oh,
Michelle's got about 100 teddies. Give her one of those.
Don't start!
That's not fair. You're the reason why she's in hospital anyway.
Felicity Jane Scully, when I say drop a subject, I mean it.
Oh, typical.
Oh, sorry, Carl. We're all a bit tired and emotional.
That's totally understandable.
Well, it's not understandable to leave a 4-year-old with a 12-year-old.
Joe.
Michelle offered to take Louise to the toilet.
Look, Michelle is still a child, Carl. She shouldn't be made responsible for a toddler.
Look, I don't think this is the time.
It's fine, really, it's fine.
I can't believe you said that.
Said what? The truth.
Oh, Brendan was passionate. He was so exciting to be around.
And that changed?
Yes, not quickly. Everything was fine at first. I don't know when it changed, but it has.
Do you still love him?
I don't know. He's possessive. It's been getting slowly worse and worse. It's hard to take. And then the violence, usually suppressed, just there beneath the surface.
But not always.
No, not always. Not last night.
When did that start?
Well, it's been pretty recent. I don't know. I've just known now that it can't go on. That's why I'm so desperate to get full-time work. I knew the time would come for me to be financially independent, so I could leave him.
And you think that time's come?
I'm sure of it.
So where was Dougal off to?
Oh, scout camp down on the coast. Here I was worrying about him when all the time I should have been worrying about you.
Oh, come on, Rose, don't go getting maudlin.
Mum, I didn't plan on doing this. It just happened.
It didn't just happen. He's always playing things like this down. He was a hero.
Lib, I was the nearest person, that's all.
You see?
Anyway, we're both glad to see you in one piece. Listen, any chance of servicing the car while we're here?
Dad, service your own car.
Ron, stop teasing him.
So how long are you staying?
Oh, only a couple of days. I couldn't get him to stay away from work any longer.
Yeah, your mother reckons the business runs itself.
It practically does. Anyway, we had to come down here and offer you our congratulations. I couldn't bear to have to hear it all over the phone.
You know, you couldn't have made a better choice. Even Dougal thinks so, and that's pretty high praise coming from him.
And I know you probably won't want to get married up our way, but I'd love you to come and stay afterwards.
Yeah, well, before, whatever.
So we can do the formal introductions?
You better make it afterwards, then. Once you meet the rest of the Rellies and work out what kind of a family you're marrying into, you'll probably want to bail out.
I've got to tell you all, I'm the happiest man alive.